Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back to Techno Terrestrian. Wait a minute, why are you looking something different on the video? I am in space. It's a great thing, right? We are in space and we are making a video in space. Great thing. So first of all, how I came here? It's a great doubt to you, right? So I came here in my friend's rocket. So you may have doubt that how do these rockets work? So I think you got today's video topic. Yes, in today's video for explain series, we are going to explain you that how the rockets work. Sounds interesting, right? So watch this video till the end and let's get started.
Guys, before getting on to know detailedly about rockets, first we have to compare them with daily using things so that we can understand it well and we can go detailed and we can know more about it. So we can compare rockets with balloons, right? A balloon which has helium filled in it will go up against the atmosphere and the gravity pressure. So similar to that, a rocket is also working. So let us see what it is. A rocket is a missile, spacecraft, aircraft or other vehicle that obtains thrust from a rocket engine. Rocket engine exhaust is formed entirely from propellant carried within the rocket before use. Rocket engines work by action and reaction and push rockets forward simply by expelling their exhaust in the opposite direction at high speed and can therefore work in the vacuum of space. So as I said, right, we can assume a rocket as a balloon and the speed at which it goes is caused by the helium, that is, with the fuel. So in fact, rockets work more efficiently in space than in an atmosphere. Multi-stage rockets are capable of attaining escape velocity from Earth and therefore can achieve unlimited maximum altitude. Compared with air-breathing engines, rockets are lightweight and powerful and capable of generating large accelerations. To control their flight, rockets rely on momentum, airfoils, auxiliary reaction engines, gimbaled thrust, momentum wheels, deflection of the exhaust stream, propellant flow, spin, and or gravity. Rockets for military and recreational uses date back to at least 13th century China. How great it is, right? In 13th century too, we had rockets, that too secretly by China. So significant scientific, interplanetary and industrial use did not occur till the 20th century when rocketry was enabling technology for the space age, including setting foot on the Earth's moon. Rockets are now used for fireworks, weaponry, ejection seats, launch vehicles for artificial satellites, human spaceflight and space exploration. Chemical rockets are the most common type of high power rocket, typically creating a high speed exhaust by combustion of fuel with an oxidizer. The stored propellant can be a simple pressurized gas or a single liquid fuel that disassociates in the presence of a catalyst, that is monopropellants, two liquids that spontaneously react on contact, that is hypergolic propellants, two liquids must be ignited to react, a solid combination of fuel with oxidizer, that is solid fuel, or solid fuel with liquid oxidizer, that is a hybrid propellant system. Chemical rockets store a large amount of energy in an easily reached form and can be very dangerous. However, careful design, testing, construction and use minimizes their risks. So many of you asked the doubt that what is a cryogenic engine? So actually, cryogenic engine is nothing but a rocket engine that uses a cryogenic fuel or oxidizer, that is, its fuel or oxidizer or gases liquefied and stored at very low temperatures. Recently, now they are using hydrogen as a cryogenic fuel.
I hope you all enjoyed this video. If you like this video and if this video was useful to you, give this video a thumbs up, share this video to your friends, and also don't forget to subscribe Techno Terrestrian to get more new awesome tech and gaming updates. And also, guys, if you have some ideas, suggestions, questions, or anything, mention that in the comment section below, you'll surely check that out. And also, guys, if you have some ideas and knowledge or any creative thinking about space, also mention that in the comment section below. So we all will enjoy it. And that's it for today. So I'll see you soon in the next one.